All right, welcome back to day two of the matrix review that we're doing. We got some vocabulary to start with. First of all, zero matrix. This is a matrix that, when added, to any other matrix yields the same matrix. Then we have the identity matrix. This is the matrix that, when multiplied, with any other matrix will yield the same matrix. Now, notice in this one, the first one, Z, that would be just all zeros. And you would put in as many zeros as you need, depending on the dimensions of the other one that you're using. The identity matrix, that one starts with a 1, and then it would be zeros to the right. Then the second one would be 0, 1, and then a bunch of zeros. Then the third one, 0, 0, 1, and then any other zeros. So the diagonal right here is always going to end up being ones, and then zeros in all the other spaces. Determinant. For a 2x2, you find the determinant by doing the following. You take these two and say A times D, and then you take these two and you say minus B times C. We use the determinant of a matrix in order to solve systems of equations with matrices. You use the determinant to help you find the inverse. We'll get to those things as we move forward. So it says add or multiply A by the appropriate matrix. It says in this one that A times I. So we're going to take the A matrix of 2, 1, negative 5, and negative 7, and we're going to multiply that by the matrix of the identity because it says I. So 1, 0, 0, 1 for this one because we have a 2 by 2. And we do the following work. We say first row times the first column. So 2 times 1 plus negative 5 times 0. That would give us our first answer because remember this is a 2 by 2 times a 2 by 2, so our answer is 2 by 2. Then it's first row times the second column. So 2 times 0 plus negative 5 times, oops, forgot my negative, negative 5 times 1. That would be the second position. Then third position would be right here, and it would say the second row times the first column. So 1 times 1 plus negative 5 times, sorry, not negative 5, negative 7. Negative 7 times 0. And then the last one here would be the second row times the second column. So 1 times 0 plus negative 7 times 1. That would be our last one. And so we would get an answer that says the following. It would say, first one would be 2 times 1 plus 0, so that's just 2. This would say 0 minus 5, so that's negative 5. This would say 1 plus 0, that's going to be 1. And this would say 0 minus 7 is minus 7. So as we can see, this does indeed give you the same answer. And it's all because of the way you have to multiply row by column. The second one, it's asking us to add zero. Well, when you do one like that, you're just adding zero to all of the parts that are here. I don't think we necessarily need to go over that, but we are adding zeros. And when you do that, you should come up with the same answer you started with. So hopefully that makes sense. I know it seems silly, but that's just the things that we do when we're trying to solve these. So, four, which of the following questions are true for the following matrices? I'm going to give you a minute to go through those and figure out which ones are right. We'll come back and talk about them. Pause the video. All right, hopefully you came up with those answers, F and L. All the other ones are going to give you something else that that you don't want to have in terms of an answer. So, let's move on to these next ones. Find the determinant. Now, finding the determinant is pretty straightforward. Find the determinant of a 2 by 2. Well, we said you take those two and you multiply them together and you get 3 times negative 6 And then you're subtracting those two, which is 30, well, 36 when you're done. I'll write it out for the sake of writing it out. This would be 9 times 4. So that makes us negative 18 minus 36, which means this is negative 54. So that would be our determinant number. And then we'd use that to help us find the inverse, but that's later. So go ahead and do that next problem. I'll pause the video here. You pause, make sure you do it. So hopefully we saw 24 minus 24, that's 0. Now, anytime you get a 0 determinant, that's going to come up later on. It's going to be in particular that you want to remember what to do with that 0. We'll talk about it then when we actually get to that point. Looking at this next one then, find the determinant of a 3 by 3. Well, 3 by 3 is a little bit different because I can't just go diagonal. If I go diagonal here, I only have one diagonal where I'm going to get the three numbers. So we do something here when we're talking about trying to find this, and it's called the following. It would say you need to augment the matrix. Augment the matrix by adding columns. Oops, let me do this real quick. Sorry, just want to make sure that I keep all this in one place here. By adding columns. All right, so what do I mean by that? Well, if I look at this one, I've got three columns, but in order to get three numbers multiplied by three numbers multiplied by three numbers multiplied, I need to add two columns to the end of this thing. So I'm going to take the first column and I'm going to add that right here. And then I'm going to take the second column and I'm going to add that right after it. Now, hopefully, what this does, or at least what you're seeing, is that it's going to allow me to take this first part of here, so it's going to come down like this. I need these three numbers, and I'm going to multiply those together. So I'm going to say 1 times 5 times 5 plus. Now, because I'm going from upper left to lower right, I'm going to be adding all of these together. So I'm going to take this one and I'm going to add that one. So 2 times 8 times 14 plus, I have one more to do right here. I'm going to be doing 1 times negative 3 times negative 2. Now, those are the three that I need to go that direction. And then I'm going to change this up a little bit and I'm going to go the other direction. So now I'm going to start at the lower left and I'm going to go this direction. Because remember, in a 2 by 2, we were doing the two diagonals. We pretty much got to do the same. Now, every one that we do from lower left to upper right is going to be a subtraction. So we are going to subtract 14 times 5 times 1. Minus this one right here, which would be 1 times 8 times negative 2, and it doesn't matter which order you list them, minus, and then I'd have this one right here, and that's going to be 5 times negative 3 times 2. And then we're going to do the math that goes with this. So when we do the math, I'm going to add the ones up top. First, I'm just going to combine them. So I get 25 plus, this is going to be 2 times that, which is 16. So that's going to give me 224 plus, this is going to be 6, and then minus 70. And then I've got a negative negative, that's going to make a plus, and this is 16. And then a negative negative again makes a plus. This is going to be 1530. And then I'm going to add all those together. And when you add them all together, you should get 231. That would be the determinant of that 3 by 3 matrix. Now, having said that, it's a lot of work, a lot going on there. You do need to know how to do a 2 by 2 by hand. That is something you do need to know how to do. But for 3x3s, they get a little long, and when we end up having trying, we're trying to solve a system, and we have a 3x3 system, that can take a while to do. So just like with most things, your calculator will help you. You do need to get your calculator out. It says use the matrix menu on your calculator to check your answer. So you're going to enter this into your matrices. So if I look at this down here, I'll open up mine. First thing I'm going to do, second and matrix, I'm going to go over here to edit and hit enter. And I want to put that original, I want to put the original one in. It was a 3x3, so 3, enter 3. And then I'm going to go, it was 1 to 1, 1, enter 2, enter 1, enter, then negative 3, enter 5, enter 8, enter, and then 14, enter negative 2, enter, and 5. And now I have it in there. So now I want to find the determinant. So I'm going to go back to the main screen, just like we did yesterday. Now I want to go matrices. I want to go over to math. I'm going to go up arrow until I get to, sorry, I don't want to go up arrow. It's right there, determinant, the first one. So I'm going to hit DET. Then I need to say determinant of matrix A. So I'm going to say matrices again. I'm going to choose A. I'm going to hit enter. And I get 231, which is what it asked me to do, is just to check my work and make sure that I get the same answer, which I did. 231, we're good. You're going to use your calculator to find the answer to this one. So go ahead and work this one out and pause the video first. All right. So hopefully we see that we end up with a determinant of 0. That does happen from time to time, and it will tell you something in particular when we get to that point. So let's take a look at this next section of vocabulary. This is saying inverse matrices. Now, in order to solve this first way we're going to learn how to solve, you have to know how to do an inverse matrix. So in order to find the inverse matrix, we first need the determinant. The inverse of a matrix A, B, C, D is like the reciprocal of a number. When you multiply a number by its reciprocal, you get 1. When you multiply matrix A by its reciprocal, you're going to get the identity matrix, which in effect is 1. That's what it's telling you. Okay, we're just trying to change it to a 1. But because it's a matrix, it takes a little bit more work. In order to find the inverse of a matrix, we're going to follow these steps. First of all, switch positions of A and D. So I'm just going to go over here and I'm going to say I'm switching the positions of A and D. So D goes here, A goes here. Then it says change the signs of B and C, but don't change where they are. So just change the signs. There's what the matrix starts as. And then you're going to multiply that by the 1 over the determinant. So 1 over, well, in this example, this would be AD minus BC. And so that would be what you would do to find the inverse of a matrix. A matrix will have no inverse if the determinant is equal to 0. And if you don't have an inverse, you can't solve. Does that make sense? Hopefully. Here, if it's 0 at the bottom of our fraction, that does make sense. 1 over 0, can't do that. Hopefully that kind of makes sense for you guys. So let's move on to this thing. It says find the inverse of this thing and show that A times A to negative 1 is going to be the identity matrix. So first thing you have to do when you are trying to solve something like this, you have to find the determinant. So we're going to do that first. To find our determinant, we are going to say determinant of this particular thing, it's going to be 3 times negative 6 minus 9 times 4. Well, we did this one before. This is negative 54. So to find the inverse, we are going to take 1 over negative 54, and we're going to multiply that by the, we got to change our matrices. So we're going to change A's matrices. Switch the upper right with the lower left and change the signs of the other two. And then you're going to multiply this out. So you're going to have negative times a negative. That's going to make a positive. So we're going to have 1 over 9. Then negative 9 times this is going to be a positive, and it's going to be 1 over 6. And then negative negative is going to make a positive again. 4 over 54, I can take 2 out of each one of those. So that would be 2 here, and it's going to be 27 at the bottom. And then 3 over this, well, that's going to be 1 over 18, and that one is negative. So here is the inverse matrices. That is A negative 1. Now what we want to do is we want to multiply A. So they said take A. We're going to do that. And we're going to multiply that by A negative 1. So 3 times 9 is going to be 4 and negative 6. And we're going to multiply that by 1 ninth, 1 sixth, 2 over 27, and negative 1 over 18. When we multiply these together, we're going to get the following. So let's just do this. Let's do it right below here. So we're going to have the following. First, we got up to 2 by 2, so we're going to end up with a 2 by 2. 3 times that, that's going to be 1/3, plus 4 times this, which is going to be 2/3. Well, that's a good start. 1/3 and 2/3, that makes 1. That's good. The next one, first row times the second column, that's going to be 6 over 27. And we are going to be adding 4 over 18. That's the second one. Then the third one, we're going to say 9. So bottom row times the first column, 9 over 9 plus negative 6 over 1 sixth. So that's going to be negative 1. That works because it's supposed to be a 0 there. Remember, we're working toward the identity. And then the last one, 9 times that is going to be 18 over 27. And we are adding 6 over 18. And, of course, you could simplify all those if you want to. I'm just going to do it now. So we should see the first one definitely was 1. The second one, if I take 3 out of this, I'm going to get 2 ninths. And I've got to add 2 ninths. Did I miss a negative here? Hold on. Just want to make sure I keep track of my negatives. Yes, this should have been a negative 4. So this is going to be 2 ninths minus 2 ninths. That's definitely 0. Then down here we had 1 minus 1. That's 0. And then 18 over 27, that reduces down to 2/3 plus 6 over that is 1/3. That is a 1, and there's the identity matrix. So you know it's the inverse when you multiply by the inverse. You know it is an inverse if you can take it, multiply it by its original matrix, and get the identity. It says make up a 2x2 matrix that does not have an inverse. Well, if we're looking for one that does not have an inverse, then what do we know? Well, we know that the determinant has to be 0, which means you could do anything. I'm just going to say 5 over 4 and maybe 2 and 10. Because then the determinant will equal 0. And so this would tell me no inverse. Hopefully that makes sense. All right, this next part says find the inverse of a 2x2 matrix. So we're just going to do what we said before. We'll find the inverse by doing some calculating. Determinant, that's going to equal 3 minus 4, which equals negative 1. So we are taking negative 1. Sorry, that was silly of me. Let me go back here for a second. It's not 3 minus 4. It is 3 minus 0, because 4 times 0 is that. which gives us a 3. That means we're going to have 1/3, and we're going to multiply that by, swap these, 3 and 1, make these negative, 0 is still the same, that's going to be this. And now we're going to multiply it in. So we're going to get an answer that says 1, 0, negative 4/3, and 1/3. And that would be the inverse of the following, the matrix we started with. You go ahead and work out this next one. Pause the video and go through it. Well, that should have been quick enough. No inverse there. Determinant was 0, so you didn't have to really do any work there. All right, last part of this. They want us to find the inverse of the following matrices using a calculator. Now, if we had to do this by hand, we'd first have to find the determinant, meaning we'd have to add 2. Then we would have to multiply that thing through by the 1 over whatever the determinant was. And that can get a little bit ugly. So let's take a look at what we're talking about. To find the inverse, we're going to do the following. First of all, you're going to grab your calculator because we don't really want to do this by hand. So here's our calculator. And we're going to do the following. We're going to say, turn it on. We're going to go to second and matrices and over to A. Hit enter. This is a 3x3. So we've already got those working. So we're just going to change the numbers. 4, 5, 8, 2, 5, 6, 9, 14, and 18. Once I have all of those, I'm going to go back to the main screen. Now it's saying find the inverse. Well, if you're using the calculator, the inverse is simply take the A and find the inverse of it. Come on. So in your calculator, that's what you're going to do. You're going to go second matrix. You're going to hit enter. And now, if you notice, the button you're using for the matrix is also raising it to the negative 1. That's the reason those buttons are linked. When you do this, you're going to get this really weird answer. So what do you need to do? Well, we don't want to put an answer like this in our matrices. So you would do the following. You say math, fraction, and then it's going to change this thing to fractions. And that's what we would be looking at. So for our fractional answer, we're going to get, what was that? Negative, was it negative 3 over 11? Just want to check. Okay. So negative 3 over 11, negative 1, 5 over 11, negative 9 over 11, 0, 4 over 11, 17 over 22, 1/2, and negative 5 over 11. Now, what it said to do now is they want you to verify this by using your calculator. So you're going to go into your calculator and you're going to say matrix A times matrix inverse A. And we should see the identity. That's what we should see when we get done. So we're going to go back to our calculator. We're going to say the following. Matrix, choose A, and then matrix, choose A again, but use the negative 1 on that one. Hit enter, and you should see we get the identity matrix. We're going to use that to solve systems in the next section. Hopefully this makes sense. If you have any questions, ask your teacher to explain something to you. Other than that, we'll see you in the next one. Bye.